My worst experiences have been not my clients.
Okay.
But somebody I wished and prayed should have been my client.
Okay.
Because, you know, nowadays what's happening, that a little setback and people go to the level of committing suicide.
Yeah.
So they either attempt it and damage one of their body parts.
Right.
Or they actually have a very, very bad end of their life.
Yeah.
So that is one area where I would like to put in more efforts and would like to have these kind of clients because I can really help them.
Right.
So my worst thing has been...
So shouldn't your focus be on, I'm just saying, you know, you know better, but shouldn't your focus be on parents? Like, you know, teach parents rather than students. Let not the students be your clients, but their parents, suffering kids, unke parents be your clients.
See, a student commits suicide because his or her girlfriend left them.
Yeah.
That is one. They got less marks in the exam.
Yeah.
They didn't get the admission where they desired.
Or they get bullied.
Yeah. Or they get bullied.
Yeah.
And sometimes parents don't have any role to play in this. They're okay. No problem. You can get admission in some other college. We'll take 1 year drop. If you want to go abroad, you want the best university in the world, no problem. Attempt one more time. Parents have become like this now.
Right.
It's no more that parents are forcing them. Mm-hmm. Yeah, of course, there are some parents who expect too much from their children. But then believe me, those children don't commit suicide.
Yeah.
It is these children
are you
who commit suicide.
Who are more
you
pampered?
Need extreme level of motivation.
Right.
And courage of facing the danger. Because if you're going to jump off a cliff, what if I survive? That is the concern. If I die, well and good. But what if I survive? I am going to be a damaged good for the rest of my life. Total handicapped. That courage they require. So that motivation comes from within. It cannot be because somebody is forcing you, somebody is making you, you know, study hard, or somebody is telling you that instead of 95, you should get 98 or 99%. Those kids don't.
I'm going to turn it a little, peeche thoda sa. You said that it's very... So the courage to... No. Is it the fear that if I survive? I didn't get that point. Like people, children who have this tendency to, you know, harm themselves or even, you know, eventually commit suicide. So they are worried that what if I survive? Is that what you're trying to say?
Yes.
That's very dark and disturbing. So
yes, it's very...
Yeah.
Because they want to die. Suppose I want to end my life. What may I want to end my life? My concern should be, what if I fail?
Okay. Are they still worried? You know, it's very...
They're worried about failure.
Are they worried about if I survive, what will people say? Or what will people talk about?
What will happen to me? What will people say? What will my parents say and do? What will my friends say and do? And now there's...
So might as well end it for good.
The law is very strict about this.
Right.
You commit suicide and there are some charges, I think, for that.
Yeah, it's a crime.
It's a crime.
They charge you. It's an offense now. Criminal offense.
Yeah, committing suicide is an offense.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's an offense.
It's a
person is, if they are dead, I mean, it would only be called suicide if they did die.
Committing suicide. The act.
The
act.
Attempt.
Yeah, the act is a criminal act.
Attempting suicide is a crime. Yeah.
Wow.
Okay, so my worst experiences so far have been, in fact, very... something like a person wanted to score marks, but he's not able to get that admission. So I give that push, and with the help of music therapy and everything, we work on his confidence levels and how he studies and focus, and then he gets good marks, something like that. So I have not really got any worse experiences. So yeah, this breakup thing is very common nowadays in teenagers. Very, very common that, you know, and the way they talk, they're so intense about it that I fell in love with him. I fell in love with her. He left me, she left me, or I had to leave, and they're very intense.
Right.
So to take them out is a task.
Mm.
But yeah, that happens with this therapist.
Right. I know I would also be considered children these days, like in that category.
You are, huh?
Shut up. But like, they amplify things to a whole new level. Like,
it's just that you can't ignore it. You can't ignore it.
Everything is like...
For
blown
people,
out of proportion.
Yeah, the thing is that it is blown out of proportion. And for us, you know, who have, you know, we're just older now, so we have more sense. So we find it funny. But the thing is that it's very dangerous. You can't ignore it. That's the point. If kids are behaving in a very, you know, that kind of, you can't tell. Kaiyon ke maa baap hote hain aise jo bolte hain, you know, I'm pretty sure if I was acting funny, right, my mom and dad would have slapped the shit out of me and they're like, you know, behave. get your shit together. Your shit. But it doesn't work with every single one. That's the point. Kids are really...
You know what? I honestly feel like, how come when we were kids, our brains work in the same way? How
right.
come when we were younger, we never behaved like this?
Because there are different people, right? You know,
tendencies. No, not, but it's changed. There's too much of exposure also.
Exactly. They see a lot, man. A
lot of exposure.
And maybe it's also about expecting a lot out of yourself. Like, self-expectation.
Yeah, yes. That's very important.
And they also tend to get very disturbed. So there's this client of mine who didn't get 500 likes on Insta.
Oh my God.
300 likes on Facebook. That was the benchmark. And all his friends...
did.
Were in thousands of likes
right.
and everything. So it was so disturbed and so stressed out and almost became violent also, as well.
Okay.
And his parents were trying to convince him that it's not a big deal. It's just Facebook and Insta.
Hmm.
That doesn't define who you are.
Right.
No, that doesn't.
They.
So there are a lot of exercises and actual counseling also helps a lot in that. Like you were saying that... being verbal, talking to a person helps a lot.
Right.
It's called as talk therapy. So
right.
it helps in these kind of cases where actually you have to play a role and talk to them, convince them that, you know, this is not the way you're thinking.